Born in a small seaside city in Italy called Genoa. His name was Christopher Colombo. Today we know him as Christopher Columbus. Mm-hmm. Our story today is on the life of this man who changed the course of history named Christopher Columbus.
Hey, ya pops! Look at this little cute baby boy! Don't you think he looks like me?
No!
No way! He's cute! You look like a ship run over your face! Rude. This boy's got the good face like his grandpa. Someday this boy's gonna grow up to be a fine weaver just like his old grandpapa.
Yes, Pops, he is going to grow up to be the greatest weaver in the world.
I think I'm going to name him Christopher Columbus. That's a fine name for a weaver.
Someday he's going to be the finest weaver in the entire world.
Little Christopher Columbus grew, but he did not share his dream of becoming a weaver. As a small boy, Columbus' interest was not in weaving thread into fabric, but his dream was to one day become a great sailor of the ocean and become the best navigator in the world.
So that's what you're gonna be! What's your idea of being a sailor? That's preposterous!
Hey, Crazy Chrissy, are you gonna be a sailor and sail around the world?
Yeah! Someday I'm going to sail west to reach the Far East.
Oh, yeah, boy, 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 boy.
And so someday I'm going to become famous.
Oh,
mermaid!
Someday they're going to name a city in Ohio after me.
Wanted him to follow in the family business, Christopher Columbus was bound and determined to follow his dream and become a sailor.
Excuse me, sir. Are you the captain of this ship?
Yep, I am.
I heard that you were in a desperate need of sailors. I'm your man, Captain.
What kind of goofy shoes are those?
You're the boy from the Columbus weaving family. Aren't you, boy?
Yep.
I have never, ever seen a weaver that knew anything about the sea. Why don't you go back and weave a shirt for
okay.
Da, 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 da.
Please, Captain, I've been studying about the sea and about being a sailor, and I've learned all there is about being a navigator. I just need a chance. If you'll give it to me, I promise I won't let you down here. Just give me a chance. Please, Captain.
Get off your feet, boy!
It's against my better judgment, but if you work hard, swamp the deck, and bring me my morning breakfast. Well, why not, boy? You're high. Stow your stuff, and we'll set sail.
Thank you, Captain, sir. One day, everybody will remember my name as the greatest navigator in the whole world.
What's your name again, boy?
Christopher Columbus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
I'm so happy I feel like dancing.
Search the world for treasure, learn science, technology. Where can you begin to make your dreams all come true? On the land or on the sea? Where can you learn to fly, play in sports or skin dive and study oceanography?
Columbus did indeed become the best sailor and navigator in the world through his hard work and consistent study. Columbus is now attempting to find a country to sponsor his very dangerous mission. Columbus wants to sail west and attempt to sail to the far east. Everyone, every country has turned him down, but Columbus is determined to find someone willing to take a chance on him and his dream. Columbus is meeting with King Ferdinand and Queen Isabel of Spain.
Ships, sir.
What route will you take?
I plan on sailing west.
Your name should be Crazy
Chris. Hey, Ferd, this guy's a slab of cheese short of a cheeseburger.
Don't you know the world is flat? You and my ships will sail right off the edge. Yeah,
No, Sir Kingness Dude, the world is round. See, I'm gonna sail around the world. And I'm gonna be rich.
Right.
And I'm gonna be famous.
Right.
And you'll be rich.
I'll be rich? Sounds good. Keep talking, Columbus.
I need 3 ships.
I'll give you 3 of my finest ships, the Niña, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria.
You'll not be disappointed, your crown ship guy. We'll all be famous when I find an all-water route to the Orient.
Hey, Ferd, maybe we should give this guy only 1 ship so all 3 of our ships don't fall off the edge of the earth.
That was a good one. And what do you hope to find, Columbus?
Oriental bananas!
Despite the crew's effort to get Columbus to turn around, Columbus kept telling them to sail west.
Merrily, 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 someday I'll be famous.
Hey, Columbus, we've been talking, and the crew from all 3 ships wants you to turn the boats around and go home.
Yeah! We're off to La Vista, baby.
How rude.
Let's turn around or we'll throw you to the sharks.
Yeah!
I'm shaking now.
Looks like we got a comedian here, boys. Now bring us home now!
That's really hurt. Okay, boys, just give me one more week. If we don't find land soon, we will turn around, go home, and I will buy everybody ice cream cones at McDonald's.
Ice cream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream.
Boy, I sure hope we find land soon before I become lunch for Jaws.
Columbus was worried. Land had not been spotted. He was on his last pair of clean underwear, and the crew was getting cranky. Rodrigo de Chinera is on the Pinta looking for land on October 12,
1492. Where'd my glasses go? Where'd they go? I found them! How did I get this lousy job as the lookout? I'm blind! I know I shouldn't have left Spain. I'm stuck on the stinking ship with smelly guys, and the food stinks! All we ever eat around here is fish. I hate fish!
Shut up, Rodrigo, and do your job. You're bumming all of us out down here.
Nag, 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 nag.
Where'd my glasses go?
Right here.
I know.
It's all good. Bumming you all, did you guys ever think about me up here, day after day after day, looking for land that never comes? What a drag. This sea air is giving me a rash. It's land! It's land! It's land! Columbus, over there in Santa Maria, it's land! Over there in Santa Maria, it's land!
Land was discovered by the crew of Columbus on October 12, 1492. But this was not the Orient, the Indies, or the Far East. The land that was discovered that day was the Western Hemisphere that Europe knew nothing about. Spain would profit the discoveries of Columbus eventually. But for those inhabitants living in the Western Hemisphere, the day Columbus landed spelled the beginning of the end for their culture and way of life.
I forgot.
Go, Peter.